Hello my dear students, welcome to your science class. Today we will study second part of our second chapter, nutrition in animals. In the first part we have studied about heterotrophic nutrition, holozoic nutrition and nutrition in amoeba. Now in this part we will study about nutrition and digestion process in humans. As I told you before also, जो भी हम food consume करते हैं या हम जो भी खाना खाते हैं that is to be broken down into simpler substances because उसमें जो भी nutrients present होते हैं वो complex components होते हैं and they have to be broken down into simpler substances because that simpler substances can be utilized in the body. So the process by which complex components of the food is broken down into simpler substances is known as digestion. And digestion in humans is a complex process. Many organs work together and they form digestive system. And another name of digestive system is alimentary canal. And digestion starts from mouth and it ends at anus. The digestive system comprises of mouth hota hai, buccal cavity, food pipe, that is also known as esophagus, stomach, liver, pancreas, small and large intestine and anus. And various digestive juices are secreted by salivary gland, liver, pancreas. They also work on the food. Food is ingested through the mouth. What is ingested? Ingested means ingestion, intake. And it starts from buccal cavity and it involves teeth, tongue, salivary gland. So the process of taking food into the body is called ingestion. We'll study teeth. Teeth help us to chew and cut or break the food into smaller pieces. Teeth is fixed in the separate socket in the gums. Teeth fix hote hain gums ke andar. And the first set of teeth is called milk teeth, jo children ke andar hote hain. And they are replaced by permanent teeth. And the visible part of the teeth is known as crown. And jo bhi part embedded hota hai gum ke andar is known as root. Crown part hota hai is covered by enamel. Humans have four types of teeth that are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Incisors jo hote hain, they are chisel shaped and there are eight incisors, four in upper jaw and four in lower jaw and they help in cutting and biting the food. Next is canines. Canines bahut sharp aur pointed teeth hote hain. They help in tearing the food. And there are four canines, two in upper and two in lower jaw. Okay, next is premolars. Premolars are broad teeth. Okay, and they help in grinding the food. And molars are again broad teeth and they help in chewing and grinding the food. And they are 12 molars, 6 each in upper and lower jaw. Next we come to tongue. Tongue is a fleshy muscular organ. Fleshy muscular organ. It is present in the buccal cavity. And what happens when we are chewing the food, tongue helps in mixing saliva and food. And digestive juices are also produced in the salivary gland. And tongue also help in swallowing the food. And tongue is a very important sense organ. और इसके टंग के ऊपर क्या होते हैं, टेस्ट बड्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं विच हेल्प अस टू डिटेक्ट फोर टेस्ट, स्वीट, सॉल्टी, बिटर एंड सॉर. देन डाइजेशन का प्रोसेस जो होता है, इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द माउथ इटसेल्फ. ओके, एंड द चूइंग ऑफ फूड इज नोन एज मैस्टिकेशन. एंड डाइजेस्टिव जूस एंड स्लाइवरी ग्लैंड दे कन्वर्ट complex carbohydrates into simple sugar, and once the food is tongue rolls it into a ball which is known as bolus. The swallowed food passes into the food pipe. Food pipe is also known as esophagus, and food pipe is pushed, food is pushed down by the movement of the walls of food pipe, which is known as peristalsis. Or ek flap hota hai, epiglottis, which prevents the food from entering windpipe. Windpipe just food pipe ke adjacent hoti hai. Next is stomach. Stomach, it is a thick walled. The cell linings of the stomach secrete three things. One is mucus, hydrochloric acid and digestive juices. Actually stomach jo hai, it is located in left side of the abdomen. ठीक है, एंड इट इज़ द वाइडेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द एलिमेंट्री केनाल. एंड डाइजेस्टिव जूसेस जो स्टोमक में सिक्रीट हुए, दे हेल्प्स इन डाइजेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन्स. और जो एसिड है, हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, ये जो भी माइक्रोब्स एंटर करते हैं फूड के साथ उनको किल करता है. एंड म्यूकस, इट प्रिवेंट्स द इनर लाइनिंग ऑफ द स्टमक. ये म्यूकस जो है इनर लाइनिंग स्टमक की प्रिवेंट करता है. And then partially digested food that is known as chyme passes to small intestine. You can see esophagus hai, esophagus is stomach, then small intestine and then large intestine. Okay, and you can see gallbladder, liver and pancreas also. Next, small intestine. Small intestine bahut hi highly coiled muscular tube hoti hai. और इसकी लेंथ होती है 7.5 meters. ये सबसे लॉन्गेस्ट पार्ट है एलिमेंट्री कैनाल का. ओके, नाउ फर्दर डाइजेशन यहाँ पे आगे प्रोसीड करता है. हेयर आई हैव मेंशन टू ग्लैंड्स, लिवर एंड पेनक्रियास. लिवर जो है लार्जेस्ट ग्लैंड है बॉडी का, एंड इट इज़ रेडिश ब्राउन इन कलर. ये बाइल सिक्रीट करता है, एंड बाइल इज स्टोर्ड इन गॉल ब्लैडर. Then bile is released into the small intestine and there it digests fat. And pancreas, it is located just below the stomach. It produces pancreatic juice which digests carbohydrates, proteins and fats. Now the food reaches to lower part of small intestine. There intestinal juices act upon it. Jo carbohydrates hai, they are broken into simple sugars. Fats, they are broken into fatty acids and proteins, amino acids में. तो ये जो simpler form है, it is easily absorbed by the blood. Now comes our next process, that is absorption. Absorption of the digestive food, it is the next step. And the inner wall of the small intestine, it has 1000 finger-like projections होते हैं, जिनको हम villi कहते हैं. Villi क्या होता है? They increase the surface or area of the for the absorption of digested food. And digested food passes into blood vessels through the surface of villi. And these substances are used up by the cells. This process is known as assimilation. Jab bhi food used up ho raha hai, is known as assimilation. Now this is villi, which you can see present in the small intestine. Next is large intestine. Large intestine is about 1.5 meter in length. Ye upper part jo hota hai iska, it is known as colon, which absorbs water and salt. And undigested part of the food is converted into semi-solid mass and then it is removed from the body. The process of removing the waste from the body is known as ejection.